Hi, good morning. Today's video is about binomial theorem, and we have some notes here. The first one, the exponent of x in each term is 1 less than the number of the term. Hence, the exponent of x in the rth term is r minus 1. So this is the number of term minus 1. That will be the exponent of x. Since the sum of the exponents of a and x in any term is equal to the is equal to n, the exponent of a in the r term is n minus r plus 1. And the third note is the denominator of the coefficient of each term in which x appears is the factorial of the exponent of x in the term. Hence, the denominator of the coefficient of the rth term is r minus 1 factorial. No? So we have four examples here so that we can describe how it operates fully. No? So for our first problem, the quantity a minus x to the fourth is equal to the first term is the power of the binomial a to the fourth plus 4a cubed minus times quantity x. No? So the x term appears on the second term since its exponent is the number of term minus 1. No? So since this is the second term minus 1, so this is the second term where x appears. No? So thus, the exponent of a will be 1 less than the second, 1 less than the the previous term. No? Plus 4 times 3, no? A squared minus times negative x squared factorial over factorial 2, no? Plus 4 times 3 times 2, no? It decreases, no? And times a times negative x cubed factorial 3 plus negative x to the fourth. So we're going to simplify finally, no? So this one is a to the fourth. Since this is negative, so the second term is negative 4 a cubed x, no? The third term is, no? 4 times 3 is 12 times, divided by 2 is 6. No? So since it's negative squared, no? That will be positive, no? Minus, no? So 4, 3, 2, no? Divided by 3 factorial, no? So what remains is 4a. So a decreases as x increases, no? 4a x cubed. And lastly, since negative x to the fourth is equal to positive, so the last term is plus x to the fourth. So this will be our final answer. So a to the fourth minus 4a cubed x plus 6a squared x squared minus 4a x cubed plus x to the fourth. Second problem is a plus 2y quantity to raised to the fourth now is equal to a to the fourth. For the first term, the second term is 4, a cubed decreases 1 to the power of a, you know. So 2y appears, you know, as the second term. So the denominator is also the power of 2y. Plus 4, 3, you know, it goes down here, 4, 3, a squared, and 2y increases as a decreases, and the power of 2y will be our denominator. So plus 4, 3, 2, no? It continues decreasing. A also decreases. 2y increases by 1 and have the factorial 3 on the to be the denominator plus 4 factorial 2y to the 4th over 4. So then we simplify, no? This one remains a to the 4th. And this one, 4 times 2 is 8. A cubed y, no? Plus, no? 12, 4 times 3 times 2 is 24, divided by 2. Not, so 24 divided by, oh, this is 4, no? 4, 3 is 12 times 4 is 48 divided by 2 is 24. A squared, y squared. So for the fourth term, we have here 4, 3, 2. And A, no? This one cancels out 3, 2, and 3 factorial, no? So what remains is 4. So 3 2 to the cube is a times 4 is 32 a y cube plus 4 factorial cancels out. So 2 to the 4th is 16 y to the 4th. So the final answer is this one. A to the 4th plus a 8 a cube y plus 24 a squared y squared plus 32 a y to the 4th cube plus 16 y to the 4th. So now we're going to have a and b raised to 5, no? A minus b raised to 5. So the first term is a to the 5th and it decreases and gets 5 to be the first coefficient. And then for the second term, b appears negative and the denominator is 1. So plus 5, 4, it decreases, so also A decreases by 1, and B increases by 1 also. And the power, the denominator is the power of 2, no? So 2 factorial, no? So this one is 20 divided by 2, no? is 10, no? A cubed, B squared, no? So this one is also negative, this one is also positive, since negative B squared is positive. So the next term is 5, 4, 3, A squared, negative B to the cube, no? So this one is 20 times 3 is 60, divided by 6 is 10. So this one is negative, no? So the next term is negative A squared B cubed, since this is the power of 3, negative to the power of 3 is also negative, plus 5, 4, 3, 2, no? And 4 factorial. So 4, 3, 2 cancels out with 4 factorial, so what remains is 5a, no, 5a, negative b to the 4th. So the last term is 5 factorial over 5 factorial, negative b, so negative b to the 5th, no? Yan. So this one is, let's check this for a while. Factorial 4, so this one is 5. So this one is positive a. So this is correct, no? The correct answer is a to the 5th minus 5a to the 4th b plus 10a cubed b squared minus 10a squared b cubed plus 5ab to the 4th minus 5b to the 5th. So the last problem is a plus 2 raised to the 5th, no? Is equal to, the first term is a to the 5th plus, brings out 5, decreases by 1, the power of a, so 5 a to the fourth. So 2 appears, the second term of the binomials, plus 5, 4, a cubed, 2 squared, increases, 2 increases by 2, and gets, and have this exponent to be the denominator. So this one cancels out, so this one is 20 times 2 is 40, a cubed, no. So the next term is 5, 4, 3, a squared, 2 cubed, 3 factorial. So this one is 5, 4, 20 times 3 is 60. 60 divided by 6 is 10, times 8 is 80. A squared, no, 80 a squared. So the next term is 5, 4, 3, 2. So this one is 4 factorial, it cancels out 4. So this one 5. And 2 to the 4 is 16 times 5 is 80a, you know. And the last term is 5 factorial, no, over 5 factorial. So this one is 2 to the 5, which is 32. So our final answer is 8 to the 5 plus 10, 8 to the 4 plus 40a cubed plus 80a squared plus 80a plus 32. So that's how we're going to solve the binomial theorem, the problem like this. No? And thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel by Wilfredo Tan, no? And click also that notification icon. Oh, I mean notification bell. So thank you, and see you again later.